Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, please bear with me for about half an hour. I know Saturday evening, weekend, and perhaps last lecture. I'll request you to just bear with me for about 35 minutes. Subject, very simple. And I hope I am able to do justice. I am able to energize you through this short talk of 45 minutes. At the outset, I thank the Young India for extending an invitation to me for delivering this talk to this August gathering. And fortunately, a very dear friend of mine has also walked in, Samarjeet, at right time. So I'll be more pepped up. Thank you. Young India has been doing a yeoman service to the nation with a single aim and single purpose and dream to see India as a developed nation. 3 days back, exactly 3 days back, Mr. Rajiv Thakkar with his colleague walked into my office with a request to address this August gathering. I was actually wondering why is he inviting me. But then I said to myself that I am invited to address young entrepreneurs, young students of Mother India. Might as well take the call. And here I am standing in front of you. Ladies and gentlemen, whatever I speak or deliver is based on my experiences and learnings in my service of 32 years with the Indian Army. Having participated in all operations during my service, having served in Kashmir 4 times, having served in Northeast 1 time, and having served in the Royal Kingdom of Bhutan 2 times. Some of the best practices which I am going to put forth are applicable to your field. If they are not applicable today, they may be applicable tomorrow. Be assured. Are there members of media here? No. Okay. Then it's okay. Please, if there is any member of media, I'll request you, please do not cover any aspect of my talk in your newspaper tomorrow. And I would also like to mention that, ladies and gentlemen, in armed forces, we are not into oratory. We excel in weapons and explosives. But it will be my endeavor through this talk to try and energize you through the best practices of the Indian Army. Now to start with, every human being is born for a purpose. He has an obligation to the nation state, to his state, to his or her society, and to his or her family. As a member of Indian Army or as members of the Indian Armed Forces, it is our obligation and duty to safeguard the sovereignty of Mother India and ensure safety and security of its citizens. You, as young Indians or young entrepreneurs, have an equally important role to play. I'll mention few. Making India an economic power. If India blooms economically, it will bloom militarily. 2.5% of GDP of Mother India goes to its defense forces. Simple. You make India economically boom, and we'll boom along with you all. Very simple. With best weapon systems, best machines, best aircrafts. Upholding the values, ethos and cultural heritage of India is in your hands. You are the future. generating employment and harnessing the potential of young Indians. This is what is expected out of young entrepreneurs. Eradicating poverty, misery, corruption, disease that prevails in the Indian society. Empowering your subordinates and their family, whether economically or mentally, is again in your hands. And not the least, fostering bonhomie, camaraderie, esprit de corps amongst all castes, all religions, and all creeds. This is what you can do. Now, what drives your army, or what drives the Indian Army? Ladies and gentlemen, Indian Army is the third largest standing army in the world, a force of 1.2 million. We have imbibed the best practices from the old British Army and then reoriented and reorganized ourselves to imbibe the best practices as per the values and ethos system of the Indian, great Indian civilization. India is a civilization, we are not a country. Testimony, liberating Kashmir immediately on raising of Indian Army post-independence is a testimony to our professional competence. Debacle during the Chinese War, 62. We reorganized ourselves, we reoriented ourselves. And the results, capture of Hajipir Pass and Pakistan territories in 1965, liberation of Bangladesh in 1971, and glorious victory on Kargil Heights during 1990 war. Mountain warfare is the most dangerous warfare. Enemy can just kill you with throwing boulders if he's occupying heights. Americans recognized our power, our military power post-Kargil war. It's the only one country which was capable of doing so, and we did it. Casualties on the Pakistani side was dissemination of a full infantry division whose dead bodies were not collected by them, but we buried them with full military honors. Indian Army, your army, is the only army in the world which has been involved in active operations, be it counter-terrorism, be it counter-insurgency, proxy war, or actual operations since last 30 years, actively involved. Even today, you know what's happening in Kashmir. By tomorrow, the operation will be over. But large number of dead bodies of Pakistanis and of course the terrorists will be collected by our forces who are in operations. I spoke to the force commander today morning. We take these operations very seriously, but aram se, koi jaldi. We don't want our men to be killed. No force in the world has witnessed or experienced such prolonged operations in their entire service. You know, we train with various armies in the world. I have students from 19 countries who are training with me in my institution. I have trained alongside the American Army, the British Army, the Russian Army, a number of them. And number of these officers and men ask us this question. What drives the troops of Indian Army for prolonged and sustained operations in the most hostile environments in the world? Well, please flash. What drives your army? Pride of wearing the uniform. Gentlemen, in civil dress or in military dress, we are thorough gentlemen, but we are tigers in uniform. That is the pride. of wearing this uniform. Not the least, honor of being a soldier. And in most cases, it's traditional. I'm a fourth generation in the Indian Army. I was looking forward to a fifth generation, but my daughter refused to join the armed forces. It's a tradition, a regimental tradition, or in families. Notwithstanding, it doesn't mean that traditional soldiers excel or they are the best leaders. Sorry, I do not mean that. Yes, they have a solid background and they also come with fire in their belly. Codes of conduct, we follow religiously. Please go to the first one. Read this. Can you read, please, in the end? In Hindi, it means Mera Desh, Mere Jawan, Main Nahi. This is an officer's code. And Indian Army officer follows this code to the hilt. Mera Desh, Mere Jawan, Main Nahi. In English, you can read this. Next, a warrior's code. Can you read in the end? Defending my nation is my dharma. Is my dharma and karam, of course. Train my mind, body and spirit to fight for this Mother India. Please read, especially the words which are in bold. So I am praying to God Almighty that, oh Lord, give me that strength to perform my dharma. Next, officer's creed. I am a leader and a warrior. Defending the honor and integrity of my country, my army and my unit is my dharma. Selfless service, professional competence is our hallmark. Leading from the front, I will explain later. When I come to leadership qualities, which every young Indian should imbibe himself. Next, please. Military values. Camaraderie, esprit de corps, bonhomie is the hallmark of military values. The core military values are integrity, in Hindi, imandari. This is very clear. Loyalty, wafadari. Duty, kartavya. Respect, samman. Selfless service, nishwarth seva. Courage, himmat, both moral and physical. Is a must. Moral courage is more important than physical courage. And not the least, honor. Honor of my country and my countrymen. Ijjat. Next. Cherished values. Patriotism. Secularism. Naam, namak, nishan. Naam, mera desh. Meri army. Meri unit. This is my naam. Namak is desh ka namak hai. And nishan is the flag under which we fight. Us flag ko nahi le jaane denge hum. The moment you capture a flag, the army is defeated. That's why Indian Army is the custodian of number of flags. We are fortunate. camaraderie as per the core I mentioned earlier, and not the least, bravery, sacrifice, dedication. And gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, most values reflected in our regiment oblique core mottos like ours is karmi dharma. Similarly, Ijjat-e-Iqbal, artillery uses, Ekta aur Balidan, Veer Hanuman, these are our mottos. Next, very important in any profession, vision, mission, aims and objectives. Unless you know this, vision statement and mission statement has to be very crisp and in one line, not in a paragraph. The objectives have to be immediate, short term, long term. There's nothing like intermediate. I don't know why people use this word. Indian Armed Forces are very clear. Our mission is one line: liberate Pakistan, liberate Bangladesh. Mission over. That was the mission in 1971 war. But our objectives, right from a subunit. Now let me tell you, a subunit is a company of about 120 troops. A unit commanded by a major sahab. A company is a battalion of about 500 bodies commanded by a colonel. A brigade is commanded by a brigadier with a strength of about 2,500 men. Then is a division, which is commanded by a major general with a strength of about 12,000 people. And then is the core. All battles are fought at core level, a strength of 62,000 troops. And then there's a theater commander, the army commander, who controls these operations. So, right from a subunit level, the objectives are well defined. A youngster knows what are his immediate objectives, what are his short-term objectives, and what are his long-term objectives. Organizational culture. You as young entrepreneurs will not be able to give your 100% output unless there is bonhami, camaraderie, freedom in your organization. Organization culture is of paramount importance to our Indian Army's soldier. And I'll briefly explain our organization culture. Please, next slide. Please come back. Can you see this circle? Can you? At the core is the warrior's code, officer's credo, and Chatwood motto, which I flashed earlier. This is the base, that's the core. Senior officers sets the organization values and moral values. Be it a subunit commander, I just told you what is a subunit commander, which is a company commander, or be it the formation commander. He is the driving force as far as the organization culture is concerned. Right. Skills, professional development, nurturing the values is the next step and very important to us. Personal aspirations to align with professional competence. An Indian Army jawan or officer is very clear from the day he joins what he wants to become. It is through his professional competence he rises, or his upward mobility is based on his professional competence. Passion, team building, we cannot survive without that. And not the least, tarteeb. Tarteeb is a way, is the way we do things. It's systematic, orderliness, methodical. Give you an example. drawing weapons from our armory. There's a drill laid down, there's a tartib. And if you don't follow that tartib, you will find excess ammunition be drawn. There's a tartib of fighting a battle, there's a tartib of fighting a war. This is the tartib we follow and religiously follow. That means every routine has a tartib. And that tartib we follow, and that is what is our organizational climate. Next, please. Sustenance of organization climate is a must, which is applicable to all of you. Directive style of command, Indian Army is not democratic. We take views, after that, commander is the boss. Orders are passed. Crisp, clear, no ambiguity. Directive style of command with delegation of responsibility down to the last man. Empowerment of your colleagues or your rather subordinates is your responsibility in the corporate world. Professional and personal, both one has to ensure. Cohesion and collective activities, and individual in isolation is nothing. He has to be part of the system, part of the organization in which he operates, or part of the obtaining environment he operates. Buddy system, this is very important in our. A soldier is never alone, he's got a buddy. Buddy goes on leave, the next guy takes over the duties of his buddy. This is practiced in peacetime and carries on in operations. Any stress on an individual immediately reported by his buddy, corrective actions are taken. Any change in his behavior, corrective actions are taken. Courtesy this buddy system. Sela Bela were two women, two sisters, who fought ferociously at Sela Pass, Boom Dola, against Chinese. Stopped the Chinese onslaught for 48 hours, along with 10 soldiers of the Indian Army. They were two great buddies, Sela Bela. Both passes today named are after those two sisters. Today also, they are dead. They died in 62, killed by Chinese. They eat and dine with the troops. If you want to see, you can go. Walk up to Sela. You two sisters eating. But only their atmas eating. The food is consumed. The buddy system is generated from there. Informal interaction. We know a pulse of every man. His family history. His generational history. Names of his children are known to us. We go down to those details because he is a comrade in arms. Raising Day Regimental. These are our historical events. This is a day, it's not a singular day, but this is a day when you salute our soldiers. A regiment develops, or whatever the name, naam jisko bolte hain, is based on its history. If you happen to go to Kashmir or along northeast, and if you want to visit a post, do give me a call. We'll ensure that you visit a post. When you go to that post, the history of that post will be recorded. This is what we do. This is a historical event. Gentlemen, Indian Army does not believe in perfection. We believe in excellence. Zero error syndrome. Agar bacche galti nahi karenge, toh aur kaun karega? We are very clear. Our youth is unleashed, totally unleashed, given full freedom, and is protected to the hilt by all of us, by seniors. Adherence to tartib, which I have spoken, training, I'll come to training later, was very important. Training enhances the self-esteem of an individual. It enables him to perform his task to the best of his ability and capability. Discipline, morale, motivation. Next. Please go back. gentlemen, leadership. It's a myth that leaders are born. Sorry. Leaders are made through training. Two examples I'll give you. General Arun Kumar Vaidya rose to become the chief of the Indian Army, came from a very humble background. Military Cross 65 war, Mahavir Chakra. Mahavir Chakra 71 war. Param Vishish Seva Medal, Sena Medal, Ati Vishish Seva Medal, Vishish Seva Medal, Padam Vibhushan. Came from a village of India. And how he died? This jewel of India was assassinated post his retirement because his security was not taken care of. Second Lieutenant Sanjay Kumar, these youngsters will know him. Paramveer Chakra, Kargil War. Son of a vendor, rose to become an officer in the Indian Armed Forces. Hero of Kaluthang, Kargil sector. He had put fear of God into the enemy. Moved to Dras sector, led from the front, got himself killed. Very humble background. But leaders par excellence. They became leaders because of their professional competence. All of you, the young lot, you can. If you have fire in your belly, you can become a good leader. A military leader leads from the front and through personal example. He is human, humble, but tiger in uniform. Calm in crisis and passes clear-cut orders and directions. Gentlemen, some of the best qualities of leaders. We call it 5 C's, D and R. 5 C's, please, these young boys who come from colleges, you please write down these qualities. If you can develop these qualities, you will become a very good Indian. You will serve this motherland to the best of your capability, in whichever field you are. Character, competence, commitment, courage. Courage both moral and physical. Compassion, decisiveness. OODA loop. I'll explain OODA loop. Observe, orient, decide, act. This is applicable to you. But you may take time to apply your OODA loop. But I have no time. I have just few minutes to apply my OODA loop. Imagine a young captain sitting with his platoon of 30 men in an ambush, expecting the terrorists or the enemy to move through the corridor, but he realizes, oh hell, that I am likely to be ambushed myself. He applies OODA loop. How much time? 5 minutes. Lifts his men, goes around, another ambush. This happens every day in Kashmir. So you also please use this OODA loop. Decisiveness, main thing. And apply OODA loop fast. You will be a successful leader. And risk-taking ability. Obviously, if you are into zero error syndrome, thank you, you are not required. We are convinced. Next. Morale. Ladies and gentlemen, high morale should not be confused with toughness, physical fitness, or happiness. Please let it be very clear. These are not indicators of high morale. It is the state of mind. It is the mental strength of endurance and courage which enables you to fight fear and fatigue. That is morale. A soldier with high morale will put his life into the line of fire. A soldier with high morale will defend his locality, last man, last bullet. We will not leave it. That is high morale. And high morale, leadership, good leadership, good discipline, camaraderie, and of course self-respect are some of the factors which affect or which are contributors to high morale. Discipline. The strongest pillar of the Indian Army is discipline. Our whole organization stands on this pillar. It is a way of life, in fact. It is a military way of life. We lead a very regimented and disciplined life. First bugle, 5:30, everyone is up. Last bugle, sleeves down, sundown. Well defined. Training. Just go to the hyperlink. These are our warriors' training ethos. Ladies and gentlemen, Indian Army is in two modes, always. Either it is training for war or it is deployed in operations or in war. There is no third mode. And in training, our stress is on holistic development of a human being, of a soldier. And what is this holistic development? Military training, technical training, personality development, and sports and adventure. We have to make him a good human being and a good citizen. We are not interested in what grading he achieves, but we have to make him a good soldier. Indoctrination is a very important aspect of our training. Imagine a bullock cart driver, 10th pass, drives a tank T-90 costing 18 crores. Can you imagine? This happens in India. A tank, each piece costing 19 crores from bullock cart driver is indoctrination to a tank driver. On board a tank, in the driver's panel or a driver's cabin, it's like an aircraft. It's actually like an aircraft. He's got 100 switches to switch on, and like a puppet, he knows what to switch on, what noise to, what sound to hear. That is indoctrination within a span of just 6 to 8 months. We train our men to lay down their lives for our country. Only organization which trains its men to lay down their lives for Mother India. That's the training we undertake. That is because of the class officer cadre who leads from the front. The officer to men casualty ratio of the Indian Army is the highest in the world. It's because of this officer cadre which leads from the front. Firmly believe, more you sweat during peace, the less you will bleed during sweat is nothing but training. Excellence in basics. Basics is what you do every day. And what are our basics? Please link. Simple. Military way of life. Well laid down. Security, training, financial probability and accountability. Huge budget, defense budget. Imagine its usage. 2.5% of GDP is directed towards us. The onus and to ensure financial probity and its accountability is with the officer cadre. A very important aspect of day-to-day life. Discipline. Other things I have already spoken about. Stress management is very important to us. Next. Human resources development. Human resources are our biggest assets. It is the man behind the machine who is the most important man and will remain so. Indian Army is not like the American Army, which is called standoff army. Ladies and gentlemen, victory is measured by foot. And whose foot? A human being's foot. You may pulverize a target by throwing missiles, explosives, bombs, but the target remains uncaptured till the time that target is physically occupied by human beings. And we do that. And we understand the importance of that human being. A young officer leading from the front with a small little section of 10 boys or with his platoon of 30 boys. Some of the Indian Army's initiatives, and by the way, in your organizations, wherever you work, it is the human beings which drive your companies, whether your private companies or which drive the corporate world. It is that potential which you have to harness. How do we harness this potential? Let's go to the next. Like I mentioned earlier, training. Training is to enhance the self-esteem of a man. If he doesn't know his job, his colleagues or his subordinates will be frowning at him. Imagine his self-esteem, zero. If he knows his job well, he'll be well appreciated. He'll be well liked. He'll fit into the wheel of that organization. So that's very important. In any organization, a small organization of 10 people to a large organization, like a huge organization like the Indian Army. Tata's lay a lot of stress on training. Satisfaction of needs. Physiological needs. Roti, kapda or makan. Very simple. And includes security needs in the armed force. If every Indian smiles, it is basically because you are, the security of this nation is assured. He will smile. I still remember my 4 tenures in Kashmir, we used to be inducted all airborne and landed Palam airport in combats, and you find complete India smiling, and we used to feel so nice. Yaar, desh toh hans raha hai, bada achha. Doesn't matter, one small valley is crying. Religious, very important in India. In every unit or a sub-unit, we have a Sarv Dharm Sthal. For us, it does not make a difference whether an individual is a Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh, Parsi, anything. It doesn't matter to us. I still remember an incident. We were on a, during exercise, we were in a breakout operation where the armor breaks out into the enemy area and goes in for a tank-to-tank battle. It was early in the morning. The tank-to-tank battle has commenced with the heli-borne operations alongside and Air Force pulverizing the target. And I was standing next to a Dhani. Dhani in Rajasthan is of about 4-5 thatched huts. And suddenly a man walked up with his bajre ki roti, mirchi and onion, saab, please, and a lassi ka glass. I said, what's wrong with you, yeah? The bloody operation is going on. Sorry. And you know what he said? He said, saab, main musliman hoon. Aap mera. I was aghast. I called my driver. Main idhar aao. Apna naam bata. Usne bataya, fir Noor Mohammed Khan. Mera naam hai, saab ka driver. Okay. After the operation, I came back. When the operation was, I sat with them and I had food. He's an Indian citizen who is equally important to me. That's why religious needs. Our men especially, they go to temples or masjids or gurdwaras every day. They are very religious. We create this. We have mobile temples, I hope you know. The temples move with us in our mobile lorries into the battle. Yeah, yeah. The troops are unleashed before the war by the Panditjis, by Granthis, by Maulvi, who recite the verses from the sacred books. And Gita is a sacred book of Indian army, which is applicable to all castes or religions. Ki hey Arjun, karam kar, yahi tera dharma. Fight. Next is recreational. Very important. How can you how can an Indian army carry on with sustained operations for 30 years? De-inducted for training, inducted for operations. Alternate tenure. We have been doing this. That's why our chests are so heavy. It's actually a fact. It's all because we take care of recreation. Leave 90 days, a jawan is authorized. He'll bloody well go 90 days by order. We create recreational activities in terms of games and sports, in terms of indoor games, movies, latest movie, UFO downloaded movie, first show is screened to our boys. And families is by orders, because that girl comes from a remote village of India, she may not have seen a film in her life. But we have to look after that young girl who is married to our army soldier. Educational needs. Upward mobility in the armed forces is through knowledge and competence. So we have our own schools within the cantonment. We have our own colleges. You name a type of college, it exists under the Indian Army. We are not dependent on others. Medical, dental, management, nursing. You name a college, it exists. It's under us. We have our own colleges and affiliate to the best universities in India. The Indian National Defense University, INDU, is coming up, like Shravanam University. After that, we'll be not dependent on any university in India. And INDU will be a top gun university of India itself. Redressal of grievance, very important. This is a daily affair. It is because we interact with our men so often. We cannot have a disgruntled soldier amongst our ranks. Happiness is more important amongst ranks. Disgruntled is not acceptable, especially when we have a regimented kind of life. This young boy from back, can you please rise? One of you? Yeah, please rise. What are you doing?
MBA.
Good. Are these applicable to you?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Please sit down. It's a fact. Honors and awards to deserving is a must. You call it incentives in terms of money. We call it these billas. Can you see? This is very important to us. Money is not important to us. We have joined the army because we have decided not to be materialistic. We are happy. The happiest and the finest organization in India is Indian Armed Forces. We are the highest paid government officials, highest paid. But we are happy because we created our infrastructure in a manner which is five star. Actually, I ride horses, I play golf, I sail, I'm an international sailor, I've sailed in every sea, every ocean, every lake in the world. God see you, Indian Army. That's the beauty. Family welfare. This is another organization with the president, chief's wife. They deal with women empowerment and looking after the children. These ladies, without any crib, behind the scenes, sincere, dedicated, overdriven, they work day and night. We have actually computer centers, English learning centers, English speaking centers, tailoring, embroidery, then classes, actually running in our every cantonment to empower these young ladies, especially who come from hinterland. Most of them can't even sign, opening their accounts, telling them how to sign checkbooks. What if her husband died? how much money will come to her. Then after she, suppose she becomes a widow or a veer nari, she still continues to be our obligation. That is where family welfare organization comes. Lifelong she is our liability. Lifelong. That is the beauty. And that is why human resources development, we have men who are ready to lay down their life, who are trained to lay down their life. Because of high happiness index, they know their families will be in safe hands even after their death. Ladies and gentlemen, these were some of the best practices which Indian Army follows. And I said earlier that these are applicable in every field. And I hope some of you, not most of you, will endeavor to apply these best practices in your organizations. I, on behalf of the Indian Army, would like to thank this nation for considering and voting the Indian Armed Forces as the best organization of the country. Last to last week, 80% of Indians have voted for the Indian Armed Forces. That is our consistent rating every year. It is a fact. Faisal is because the nation salutes us, the nation loves us. Now the question is, why does the nation salute its armed forces? We take pride in safeguarding the sovereignty of Mother India and pride in safety and security of our citizens. We are professionally competent to undertake all types of operations in all types of environments, in all types of terrains. We are the last instrument of national security, and we will remain so. We are a disciplined, secular, and apolitical force. We also render aid to civil authorities as and when required. The recent disaster in Uttarakhand is well known to all of you. It is the armed forces which rescued 3.25 lakh people. Your two small little buildings collapsed in Baroda, and we were there in half an hour. Those 11 dead bodies and 3 live people were recovered by us by them. So we also aid civil authorities at the time of disaster. We undertake Sadbhavna in hinterland for poorest of the poor. We are the best in environment preservation and upgradation. The National Environment Preservation Award for last year 10 years has gone to Indian Army. Just for your information. We uphold the pride and dignity of all our countrymen. We do not tolerate human rights violation. We are very firm. A young officer was charged for rape in Kashmir Valley. Within 3 months, he was put behind bars, dismissed from service and put behind bars. Even a fast track court cannot do that in India. He's still in Tihar jail. Projecting India as an international power through our professional competence and through our peacekeeping and peacemaking operations under the United Nations banner. Gentlemen, I wonder how many of you have seen that movie Black Hawk Down? Yes. You saw the American heroes, but please let me tell you the truth. The bloody American army withdrew through us. Okay. They were very happy. UNOSOM, I was part of UNOSOM too. They withdrew through us. And they were very happy when Indian Army landed in Somalia. The warlord, Aidid, who was the warlord, was, by the way, trained by us only. Okay. So these are credentials. The largest UN contingent today is ex-Indian Army in the world, largest even today. That is how we project ourselves as international military power. Gentlemen, in the end, I am very thankful to Youth India for having given me this opportunity to address all of you, and I hope I am very much within my time limits. Questions, if any, please, if it is a question pertains to national security, I may not answer, if it is a sensitive question. But any other question, whether first dimension of warfare or fourth dimension of war, or asymmetric warfare, you are most welcome.
We will actually have time for only two questions.
So. Okay, very good, thank you. Less the better. Hi, Vinod. Good.